Very good morning, cadets. So chapter number 2, that is from trade to territory, syllabus for your monthly test examination. So in the last video session I completed the chapter. Today let us discuss the question and answers related to the chapter. I repeat, the chapter number 2 from history, that is from trade to territory, syllabus for your examination, that is your monthly test, scheduled from next week onwards, next Monday onwards, from 12th onwards. First one, match the following: Diwani, Tiger of Mysore, Faujudari Adalat, Rani Chennamma, Sipahi. In the column B, Tipu Sultan, right to collect the tax, the land revenue, Sipahi, criminal court, led anti-British movement in Kitpur. Fill in the blanks. British conquest of Bengal began with the Battle of Dash. Hyder Ali and Tipu Sultan were rulers of which region? That is what you have to say. Dalhousie implemented doctrine of Dash. Maratha kingdom were located mainly in the Dash part of India. State whether true or false, the Mughal Empire became stronger in the 18th century. English East India Company was the only European company that traded with India. Maharaja Ranjit Singh was the ruler of Punjab. The British did not introduce administrative changes in the territories they conquered. Question and answers. What attracted European trading companies to India? What were the areas of conflict between the Bengal Nawabs and East India Company? How did assumption of Diwani benefit East India Company? Explain the system of subsidiary alliance. In what way was the administration of the company different from that of Indian rulers? Describe the changes that occurred in the composition of company's army. So 9 questions, including match the following, fill in the blanks, true or false. Take your pen and get ready to write the answers. Let us start. Diwani means what? Diwani means right to collect the tax, that is land revenue. Tiger of Mysore, Tipu Sultan. Faujudari Adalat means criminal court. Rani Chennamma led anti-British movement in Kittur. Sipahi means Indian soldier. So the British conquest of Bengal began with the Battle of Plassey. That is, can you recall the year? 1757. Hyder Ali and Tipu Sultan were rulers of Mysore. Lord Dalhousie implemented doctrine of lapse. So Dalhousie implemented the policy of doctrine of lapse. Maratha kingdoms were located mainly in the southwestern part of India. So write down answer for fill in the blanks. Now let us move to the next one, that is state whether true or false. The Mughal Empire became stronger in the 18th century, that is false, because after death of Aurangzeb, actually Mughal Empire lost its control, and after death of Aurangzeb Mughal Empire became very weak, so definitely it is false. The English East India Company was the only European company that traded in India, with India. That is also false, because Portuguese, French, even Dutch, they traded with India. So English East India Company was not the only company. So English East India Company was the only European company. Sentence is false. Maharaja Ranjit Singh was a ruler of Punjab. That is true. The British did not introduce administrative changes in the territories they conquered. That is false, because British introduced the system of Faujadari Adalat, Diwani Adalat, introduced several changes in civil administration, criminal administration, and even in the administration of army or the defense forces. Let us move to detailed answer. What attracted European trading companies to India? European trading companies were attracted to India because of number of reasons. Trading with India was highly profitable and fruitful to the businessmen in Europe. The European trading companies purchased goods at cheaper rate and sold them in Europe at a higher price. So European trading companies purchased goods at cheaper price and sold them in Europe at a higher price. The fine qualities of cotton and silk produced in India had a big market in Europe. So fine qualities of cotton and silk produced in India had a big market where in Europe. Indian spices like pepper, clove, cardamom, cinnamon were in great demand in Europe. Question number 5. What were the areas of conflict between Bengal Nawabs and East India Company? In the 18th century, after death of Aurangzeb, the Bengal Nawabs asserted their power and autonomy through 18th century. The conflict between them and East India Company intensified. The Nawabs refused to grant company concessions, demanded large tributes, denied it the right to mint coins, and stopped it from extending its fortification. They claimed that the company was depriving the Bengal government of huge amount of revenue and also undermining their authority by refusing to pay tax. Writing disrespectful letters and humiliating them and their officials. On the other hand, the company declared that its trade was getting ruined because of the unjust demands of local officials. The company believed that the trade could only flourish if duties, means tax, were removed. To expand trade, it wanted to enlarge its settlements, buy up villages and rebuild forts. Number 6. How did the assumption of Diwani benefit the East India Company? The Diwani right to the British East India Company benefited it in several ways. The Diwani allowed the company to use the vast revenue source of Bengal. The East India Company monopolized trade and began direct plunder of India's wealth. Revenues from India financed company expenses. These revenues were used to purchase cotton, silk, textile in India, maintain company troops and meet the cost of building of the company fort and offices at Calcutta. The company used its political power to monopolize trade and dictate terms. They could impose their own prices that had no relation to the cost of production. The company used revenue of Bengal to finance exports of Indian goods. So how did assumption of Diwani benefit East India Company? You know very well, Diwani is nothing but right to collect the tax. The British East India Company received the right to collect the tax. Naturally, their source of income increased, and as a result, more authority exercised by them. Question number 7. Explain the system of subsidiary alliance. After the Battle of Plassey in 1757, the Battle of Buxar in 1764, the gaining of Diwani of Bengal, the company began to expand its rule in many parts of India. For that, it has devised several plans. Among them was subsidiary alliance according to the terms of alliance. So subsidiary alliance is one among them. What are the terms of subsidiary alliance? First, Indian rulers were not allowed to have their independent armed forces. Second, they were to be protected by the company but pay the subsidiary forces that the company was supposed to maintain for the purpose of their protection. If the Indian rulers failed to make payment, then the part of territory was taken away by the company as penalty. For example, in 1801, the Nawab of Awadh was forced to give half of his territory to the company for failing to pay for subsidiary forces. So according to subsidiary alliance system, the kingdom which signed the treaty of subsidiary alliance, if failed to pay the subsidiary dues, then definitely the large part of their territory is taken as the penalty for not paying subsidiary dues. Question number 8. Of course, you can reduce one or two points, no problem, because it's a very detailed answer. There is no need you have to memorize all the points. What was the administration of the company? In what way the administration of the company different from that of Indian rulers? Answer: British territories were broadly divided into administrative units called presidencies. There were three presidencies: Bengal, Madras, and Bombay. Whereas under the Indian ruler, administration was divided into four parts, that is Jilla, Paragana, Tehsils, and villages. Each administrative unit was ruled by a governor. The supreme head of administration was Governor General, whereas under Indian administrative system, the supreme head was King or Nawab. Lord Warren Hastings introduced a new system of justice. Each district was to have two courts, that is civil and criminal court. The European district collector, presided over civil courts. Criminal courts were still under Qazi or Mufti. Under the Regulating Act of 1773, a new Supreme Court was established. The main figure of an Indian district was collector. According to the title collector, his main job was to collect the revenue and the taxes and maintain law and order in his district with the help of judges, police officers, and dorgas. Elaborate answer. Of course, you can reduce it, no problem. Ninth one. Describe the changes that occurred in the composition of company army. I repeat, this is syllabus for your monthly test. During 18th century, when East India Company began to recruitment for its own army, it started recruiting peasants and began training them as professional soldiers, like Mughal army, the company's army. It was also composed of cavalry, infantry regiments, with cavalry dominating the army. However, as a welfare technology changed during 19th century, the cavalry requirement of the company army declined. As the soldiers had to be armed with the muskets and matchlocks, the infantry requirement became more important. So, question number 9. So, cadet, this is 8. 7, 6, 5 4 3 2 and 1 match the following. So write down. Thank you. Wish you a wonderful day. Thank you.